In life, it cannot happen that you succeed each and every time. Failure is just a part and parcel of life, and everyone has to go through it. There will be ups and downs in your life, and nobody can prevent that. Only one thing that we can make sure is that whenever we fail better. We learn from our experiences and grow. यार जिंदगी में ना कभी भी कोशिश करने से नहीं डरना चाहिए, क्योंकि अगर कोशिश ही नहीं करी तो फिर तो ऐसे ही हार गए ना यार। तो बस बिना डरे आगे बढ़ते जाओ, क्योंकि आखिर क्यों डरे, जिंदगी में क्या होगा, कुछ नहीं होगा तो तजुर्बा होगा, एंड दिस एक्सपीरियंस माई फ्रेंड विल राइट योर सक्सेस स्टोरी। Hi everyone, this is Soumya this side. Welcome back to another video in my channel. In today's video, we will be discussing about negotiations. I will discuss about my journey of how I switched from Arcesium, which is a subsidiary of D.E. Shaw and already a pretty decent company, to Amazon at an increment of 80% in my yearly salary. So if you are someone who wants to learn these negotiating techniques, or are simply interested to listen to what I did to achieve this, then stick around till the end of the video. I am sure you will not be disappointed. So without further ado, let's get started. First and foremost, you should always remember any offer that anyone puts in is always negotiable, no matter what. You should always remember this. And why I am saying this, or why is it even necessary to tell it? Because it's a fact that only 46% of males and 34% of female candidates negotiate a salary offer. The rest do not. And I must say, you are missing out on a huge portion of your salary throughout your career without negotiating. तो हमको ये चीज हमेशा दिमाग में रखनी ही पड़ेगी कि जो भी ऑफर दे, कोई भी हो वो ऑफर हमेशा नेगोशिएबल होता है।
हम मालूम है तेरे बाप को मत सिखा, चल।
Now, the first and foremost, the most important thing that you should always know is your value. What is it that you are bringing to the table? Your experiences, your expertise in the language, and always use that as leverage. In this regard, your interviews do reflect very much about the value that you can bring into the firm. The better you give your interviews, the better is your impression with the hiring manager. The better your impression is with the hiring manager, the more they want you in their team, the more they want you in their team, the better offer they will release. So always make sure that your interviews go as good as possible. Negotiations ke chances bahut 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 zyada badh jate hain agar aapka interview acha jata hai. To hamesha know your value, what you are bringing to the table, display that to the hiring manager, showcase your talent, crack the interviews with amazing, amazing feedback as much as possible. And that will definitely help you in your negotiation tactics. For example, mere case mein, in my interview with Amazon at an SD2 level, I had given 5 rounds of interviews and the feedback from all the 5 rounds was very good. Because of which, it boosted my chances of getting a good offer from Amazon. I have talked with a lot of people here in Telegram, in LinkedIn, in Instagram, who are in this process of, you know, job offers, who are trying to switch between companies or select a few companies. And I have seen one thing. यार ऐसा नहीं होता है, कंपनी ने इतना रिसोर्स इन्वेस्ट करा है, इतने पैसे डाले तुम्हारे हायरिंग के लिए, वो ऐसे कभी भी ऑफर रिजेक्ट नहीं करेगी. सो यार गो अहेड एंड नेगोशिएट, पूछने में कुछ नहीं जाता. सो डू नॉट फियर दैट द कंपनी विल टेक योर ऑफर अवे, डू नॉट फियर दैट यू विल लुक ग्रीडी इन फ्रंट ऑफ योर टीम. That doesn't happen. Everyone feels good if the person who is coming in a particular team knows their value. Agar tumko tumhari value pata hai, tumko tumhare skills pata hai, tum usko showcase karte ho, to ek hiring manager kabhi bhi bura nahi manega. For that hiring manager, you and your happiness is very, very important. Kyunki agar employee happy nahi hai, agar employee khush nahi hai, then the employee will not be contributing properly to the team. Hence, your hiring manager is actually working with you so that you get an offer that you are satisfied with. And again, one thing that I would say, negotiations are not at all unethical.
Why? Why, Dada? Why?
This is business.
This is my swag.
I know, but
negotiate. One should always negotiate because you should be paid at par with the value you generate as well as the skills you possess, and not on the basis of your previous compensation. Hence, you should always, always negotiate for what is right. Third thing is do a lot of market research. That is extremely important. You need to know what is the salary range that a company can offer at a particular level. You need to know what is the exact compensation breakdown as well as salary structure that the company offers at each and every level. And this information is very important. And why it is important, you may ask, because each of the component is negotiable. And if each of the components are negotiable, you having the most amount of information around these components will help you negotiate your salary better. Market research कैसे कर सकते हैं? यार मैंने 14 company reviews के video बना दिए हैं अभी तक, till I have released this video, and many more are in the pipeline. Go and subscribe to my channel if you have not subscribed already, and look through those 14 videos that I have made for you, as well as more that are coming out. I can assure you, you will get exact insights around each and every company that I cover. In those videos, I have talked about the interview process, when the interview happens, how to crack it. I have talked about the compensation structure as well as breakdown at each and every level in that company. और सब्सक्राइब करो, लाइक करो और कमेंट करो कौन से कंपनी की वीडियो में बनाओगे। द लाइक टारगेट फॉर दिस वीडियो इज 1,500 लाइक्स। तो यार इफ यू सी नीचे कि लाइक 1,500 से कम है, जाके लाइक कर दो यार, चैनल के लिए अच्छा होगा। ये वीडियो से जो कंटेंट मैं लेके आ रहा हूं और भी लोगों तक पहुंचेगा। शेयर इट अमंग योर फ्रेंड्स एंड पीयर्स और एनीवन व्हाटसोएवर हुम यू फील दीस टिप्स विल बी हेल्पफुल। एंड वन मोर थिंग, दिस इज माय इंस्टाग्राम हैंडल, है जाके फॉलो करो, डेली कंटेंट पोस्ट हो रहा है वहां पे भी, यूट्यूब से अलग मस्त बातें करेंगे यार वहां पे। फॉलो करो और मैसेज करो मेरे को। This video is sponsored by Cryo and they have a special message here. So Cryo is a project-based learning platform that helps you to build internship level projects so that you can improve your resume as well as improve your software development skills so that you can land great job offers from top tech companies. Here actually you get your hands dirty and build several projects from scratch. Not only this, they also provide placement assistance. There are two major courses. One is for the full stack developer, the other one is for the backend developer. You will get free trial for both of the courses. Not only this, if you do wish to actually avail discounts on those courses, you can get a 10% discount. All you have to do is go to the link in the description below, unlock your email ID here, and get the 10% extra off by putting my name as the coupon code. One more thing that you should always, remember in your mind is the minimum acceptable number. Now, what is a minimum acceptable number? Minimum acceptable number is the lowest salary that you will accept an offer for. उसका मतलब अगर कोई कंपनी तुमको ऑफर करती है एट अ लोअर सैलरी रेंज, एट अ लोअर सैलरी देन दैट ऑफ योर मिनिमम एक्सेप्टेबल नंबर, ऑब्वियसली नेगोशिएट विद दैट कंपनी, एंड इफ दैट कंपनी डजंट इंक्रीज दैट, देन बी प्रिपेयर्ड टू वॉक अवे फ्रॉम द ऑफर, रिजेक्ट द ऑफर देन एंड देयर। माइंड यू शुड ऑलवेज बी प्रिपेयर टू वॉक अवे फ्रॉम द ऑफर, बिकॉज इफ यू डू दैट, आई हैव सीन मेनी टाइम्स company come back with a higher offer just because they don't want to invest so much time, so much money, so much resources just to interview for that position again. That's why it is extremely important to have and know your minimum acceptable number below which you will reject the offer. Now, whenever the recruiter asks you to give a range or an expected compensation, expected salary, what you should do, you should take your minimum acceptable number, always add 15% to it, and then quote that figure as your expected yearly salary. And why I am saying this is because generally, whatever you come back with, the recruiter will try to negotiate and bring the salary down. And this is exactly what I did. When the Amazon's recruiter asked me about my expected compensation, obviously I had done my market research. So I knew exactly what the compensation band for an SD2 at Amazon is. Yearly salary kitna milta hai ek Amazon SD2 ko, uske band ka mereko pura pura idea tha. I had my minimum acceptable number. I added 15% to that number and gave out that figure as my yearly expected salary. And to my surprise, Amazon came back with a salary which was even more than what I had asked for. So I don't have any complaints there.
अरे कौन भौंक रहा है ये बदतमीज?
The best thing that you can do while negotiating is have multiple job offers. If you have a multiple job offers, obviously your leverage increases and you will be able to use one offer to get higher compensation from the other company. Now, in order to achieve this, you need to follow certain steps. First and foremost, do proper market research, which is obviously important, and for that, see my videos. Second, understand what is the exact range of salary at your level at all of the companies where you would want to interview. Now, always line up your interviews such that jo company sabse kam salary deti hai, uska interview pehle ho, aur jo company sabse zyada salary de sakti hai, uska interview ekdam last ho. Taki, as and when you go through the interviews and get corresponding offers, you can use the lower offer to get a higher offer from a company which can potentially pay you more. And correspondingly use that higher offer from the third company, which can pay you even more than that and increase your salary. Something along the similar lines I also did. I had multiple job offers with Twilio and Indeed when I was giving my interview at Amazon, and I had that leverage with me in order to justify my expected compensation. Always remember, you and your employer are in the same team. They want the same thing. What is the same thing they want? They want to roll out an offer, and you want to get an offer which you are satisfied with. Why? Because koi bhi company ye nahi chahega ki uska employee kaam karne ke bajaye ye soche din bhar ki usko baakiyon se kam salary mil rahi hai. Because obviously his or her work will be impacted, and that person will not be able to contribute as effectively as the company would want. Ye sirf tumhare liye nahi hai, tumhare benefit ke liye nahi hai. Tumhara benefit to hoega hi hoega, but iske sath sath company ka bhi benefit hoga. Hence, you should always negotiate, and always use this point while negotiating. One thing that you should always note is, while negotiating, always be humble, always be polite, and do not or disrespect or be arrogant, because that doesn't help. You being humble and you being polite goes a long way while negotiating anything. However, I must say, with being humble and polite, you should always be confident. Agar tum confident nahi ho apne skills pe, tum confident nahi ho what value you bring to the table, then you will never be able to make your prospective employer, recruiter ho ya hiring manager ho, realize the value that you bring to the company. And if you are not able to realize then that value, you will not be able to get the desired increment that you want. And last but not the least, take your time. It's your decision, it's your life. One bad offer and you can screw up your compensation for the next few years you are in that company. So take the time. Recruiters will pressurize you no matter what. They will do that. But you should always, always, always push back and take your time to decide on the offer. These are the few tips, techniques, you may say, that I followed, that I did, which helped me in getting an 80% increase in my yearly salary. From when I was working in RCGM, which is a subsidiary of the eShop, already a good company with a good salary, to Amazon in just one switch. And agar koi bolta hai ki yaar sirf 30 to 40% increment hi hota hai at the later stages, that is wrong. No, isse zyada hota hai. People just don't want to admit it or tell everyone so that people negotiate. So more power to you guys. Go ahead and negotiate your salary. Go ahead and negotiate as much as possible so that you are paid according to your worth. I really hope that you like the video. If you did, then hit the like button. Aaj is video ke liye like target apan rakhte hain 1.5000 likes ke liye. Agar aapko niche dikhta hai ki like 1.5000 se kam hai, to jaake like kar do yaar. Video ke liye kafi acha hoga. Apart from that, share it among your friends and peers and subscribe to the channel if you have not already. Kya kar rahe ho? And hit that notification bell. This is Soumya Jit bidding goodbye. Daste Daniyar.